What do you think of when you think of cryogenics? Futuristic science? Freezing your body for the future? Did you know that NASA does research in cryogenics? Cryogenic rocket fuel, that is. It's called cryogenic because it's extremely cold, down to minus 423 degrees Fahrenheit. Cryogenic rocket fuel is made up of liquid hydrogen and liquid oxygen. These liquids are stored in special tanks inside the rocket. When the rocket needs to launch or travel in space, the fuel is mixed and ignited, which creates a powerful explosion that propels the rocket. It also has the advantage of being very lightweight, which is important for space travel, where we need to carry as little weight as possible in order to travel as far as possible. But because these fluids must be kept at very low temperatures, handling and storing can be a real challenge. This is where you come in. You will design and build a prototype of a cold fluid storage device and transfer system using everyday items you can find in your classroom or home. Your storage container must hold a minimum of 30 milliliters of rubbing alcohol for at least 24 hours without losing any liquid to evaporation or leakage. Then transfer the liquid from the cold storage container to the fuel tank of the spacecraft. To get a baseline for comparison and general understanding, try this out the day before you plan to do the challenge. Measure out two small cups or beakers, each with 30 milliliters of room temperature tinted rubbing alcohol. Leave both uncovered, but place one in a room temperature or warm area and the second in a refrigerator or freezer. The bigger the temperature difference, the better. Be sure they will remain untouched until the next day, at least 24 hours later. The next day, measure and compare how much liquid is left in each and measure the temperature. This will demonstrate how evaporation and temperature are related. Once you understand the relationship between temperature, evaporation, and the use of cryogenic fuel for NASA, it's time to design and build your cold storage container and transfer system. To ensure success, remember, seal it tightly, keep it cold, if you can. Put a paper towel under the storage container so that you can see if any leakage occurs and then evaporates. And be sure you're using tinted liquid. Once both the storage container and transfer system are complete, fill the storage container with 30 milliliters of chilled rubbing alcohol. Then leave your storage container in a room temperature area for at least 24 hours. Be sure to record the initial temperature and masses in your data tables. Remember, the transfer will be done in space, so everything must be connected during the initial build. Time to see how much evaporation occurred over 24 hours. Collect your data, and then transfer the liquid from the storage container to the fuel tank of your spacecraft. We recommend using a measuring device as your spacecraft's fuel tank to make things easier. Evaluate your designs. How well did the transfer systems work? If you have time, redesign, build, and try again. Just like a NASA engineer would.